We present AirCode, a method to tag physical objects. The codes are imperceptible to the human eye, yet machine-readable using our imaging method. Here is an image produced using our method. After decoding, we reveal the hidden word, visibility. Subsurface scattering is universal for almost all 3D printed materials. Some light rays are directly reflected by the surface to the camera, contributing to the direct component of the image. Other light rays penetrate the surface and scatter inside the medium before reaching the camera, contributing to the global component. When the material structure under the surface changes, the direct component is unaffected since it is composed of light rays reflected by the surface. But the scattering rays inside the object will be affected, resulting in a different global component. We manipulate the global component by simply placing air pockets under the surface and thereby tag the fabricated object with user-specified information. To make the air pockets invisible yet machine-readable using our imaging setup, we optimize the depth and thickness of air pockets. We use a projector camera setup to detect air codes. By projecting checkerboard patterns onto the object, we can separate out the global component of a scene. We place three air pockets inside a 3D printed square slab. Here is a view of a cross-section. While the three air pockets are discernible in the global component image, the air pocket shapes are generally noisy and blurry. To address these artifacts, we design a coding structure and propose a robust decoding algorithm. We introduce markers and bits in the design of air codes. For the markers, we use a concentric circular shape which is robust against blurriness and camera distortion. Once we locate four markers, we apply a four-point perspective correction to rectify the image. To uniquely determine the code orientation, we identify the bottom right marker by placing air pockets around it. To recognize individual cells as binary bits, we place several known bits to enable on-the-fly supervised SVM training. The remaining cells are classified using this SVM classifier. We now show a few application scenarios for air codes. We can embed metadata in physical objects. Here we embed a word in this piece, in the global component, we decode the message. More generally, we can embed metadata into customized shapes, very much akin to the metadata stored in photographs, such as website links, producer names, and copyright information. In this example, we embed a link to the statue's Wikipedia page. AirCode can help robotic manipulators interact with man-made objects. With the markers detected, not only are we able to retrieve a message, but also estimate the pose of the object. In the triangular drawer, we embed three different codes in each of the side faces. The codes specify the 3D shape of the object, while the markers help to estimate its orientation and location. The shape and pose together allow the robot to plan its grasping motion. In a more challenging case, where the hand was completely occluded, the robot can still recognize the object and know the handle position to succeed a grasp. Here's another example where we also embed multiple codes on a curved surface of a mug. The idea of air code can be transferred to other materials beyond 3D printed ones. In this example, we create air gaps in multi-layer paper. The air gap is invisible, but is revealed in the global component image. Here we use four layers of paper. The first two layers are blank. The third layer contains air gaps and embedded a hidden message. The top layer is printed with regular text. This is the separated, direct, and normalized global component. We use a direct component to create a binary mask for the text and a standard inpainting algorithm to remove the overlaying text. This gives us the clean embedded text. Thank you.